Good morning, class. In the previous lecture of chapter number 4, Agriculture, we had studied the importance of agriculture, the different types of farming methods, the different cropping seasons, and we had discussed about what are the requirements of temperature and rainfall of wheat and rice. And now we are going to study about millets. Now, what are millets? Jowar, bajra, and ragi. These three crops are considered as millets. They are highly nutritional. Nutritional means they have high proteins, fats, proteins. All these nutritions are in these millets. Now we are going to discuss this one by one. Jowar. It is a rain-fed crop and need no irrigation. Rain-fed crop means it has the requirement of rainfall and no irrigation system is used in the agriculture of jowar. It is the third most important crop with respect to area and production. Now, in respect considering area and production, it is the third most important crop. The first was rice, second was wheat, and this is the third most important crop which uses a lot of area and a lot of production. Maharashtra, Karnataka, MP and Andhra Pradesh are the major jowar producing areas. So, these areas produce jowar the most. Secondly, we have bajra. It grows well in sandy and shallow black soil. Now, what is the requirement of bajra? The requirement of bajra is that it needs black soil and sandy type of soil in which it can grow in a better condition. Rajasthan, UP, Maharashtra, Gujarat and Haryana are the major bajra producing states. So these are the states which produce bajra on a higher content. Third, we have ragi. It's crop of dry region. Dry region means where the rainfall content is very less or there is no rainfall. So it is considered as dry region. So it is a crop of dry region. It grows well in red, black, sand, loamy and shallow black soil. So these are the requirements of soil that these can grow in type of red soil also, black soil, sand, loamy and shallow soil also. Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Himachal Pradesh, Arunachal Pradesh are the major ragi producing states. So these are the states which produce ragi the most. Now next is maize. We had studied about wheat and rice and now we are going to study about maize. Maize, it is a kharif crop used as food and fodder. Kharif crop, I also discussed in the previous lecture that kharif crop requires, it starts on the onset of monsoon and it is harvested in September and October. So it is a kharif crop and it is used as food also and fodder for animals also. It needs temperature between 21 degrees Celsius to 27 degrees Celsius and grows well in old alluvial soil. Old alluvial soil was the bangar soil. We had studied about two types of soils, alluvial soil that was khadar and bangar. It needs bangar type of soil that is the old alluvial soil. And the temperature requirement is 21 degrees Celsius to 27 degrees Celsius. It can be grown as rabi crop also. Now, as it is a kharif crop, it can also be used or it can also be grown as a rabi crop. HYVs, fertilizers and irrigation have helped to increase agriculture production. Now in the production of maize, HYVs means high yielding variety seeds are also used, fertilizers are used and new irrigation systems are also used for the production of maize. Karnataka, UP, Bihar, MP are the major maize producing states. So these are the states which produce maize the most. Then we come to the major crop of pulses. Now pulses, we means udad, moong, tuwar, all these are considered or come in the category of pulses. India is the largest producer as well as consumer of pulses. Producer as well as consumer. India is the largest producer also and consumer also. It is a great source of protein. So this type of pulses have a high nutrition value. It has a high kind of proteins and nutritions. They can be grown in kharif as well as rabi season. So in kharif also they can be grown. They can be grown in the rabi season also. They are leguminous crops, so grown in rotation with other crops. Now means whenever you are growing one crop, you can produce them or you can make their agriculture also compared to the other crop. You can grow it with the other crop also in rotation with the other crops. For example, tur, moong, arad, masoor, peas and gram. These are all the pulses. Then we have the sugarcane. It's tropical and subtropical rolling. Means sugarcane can be grown in the tropical areas as well as the subtropical areas. It grows in hot and humid climate with temperature around 21 degrees Celsius to 27 degrees Celsius. So the requirement of sugarcane, the temperature is 21 to 27 degrees Celsius. It requires the rainfall around 75 centimeters to 100 centimeters. So the requirement of rainfall is 75 to 100 centimeters. It can be grown with the help of irrigation in variety of soil. Now, whatever type of soil it has, with the help of irrigation, it can be grown in any area. It is labor intensive crop, means this crop requires a lot of labor. This crop requires a labor culture also, so it is a labor intensive crop. India is the second largest producer of rice after Brazil. So the first most important producer of this sugarcane is Brazil, and second largest producer of sugarcane is India. UP, Maharashtra, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh are the major sugarcane producing states. So these are the states which produce sugarcane the most. Then we have the oilseeds. India is one of the major countries in the world in production of oilseeds. So oilseeds also, India is a largest producer, or we can say the most of the production of oilseeds is done in India. It covers around 12% of the total cropped area. Whatever cropped area we have, it covers 12% of the total cropped area. India produces almost all kind of oilseeds and used to produce edible oil and for cosmetic and ointments. Now these oilseeds are used to produce oil also, and it is also used for cosmetics also. Some oilseeds are grown as kharif and some are grown as rabi crops. So they have different requirements of temperature and rainfall. They can be grown as kharif season also, and some oilseeds are there, they are, can be grown as rabi crops. Gujarat is the largest producer of groundnuts. So groundnut, till, all these are oilseeds, and these, and in this, Gujarat is the largest producer of it. Then we have tea. It's grown in plantation agriculture. Plantation agriculture, I firstly also said that plantation agriculture is means growing a single crop. So tea is grown in a plantation agriculture. It's tropical and subtropical crop grown in well-drained soil. Where the soil have well-drainage or well-drained system, it is grown in that soil in tropical and subtropical areas also. It needs frequent shower evenly distributed for the growth of fresh leaves. Now what happens in this plantation, it requires a frequent shower, means just a rainfall and then no rainfall. It is the requirement of frequent showers so that the leaves can be fresh. It is labor intensive crop. It also requires a lot of labor. Assam, West Bengal, Kerala, Tripura are some of the major tea producing states. So these are the states which produce tea. India stands second in tea production after China and Turkey. So China and Turkey are the largest producer of tea, and after China and Turkey, India is the producer of tea. Then we have coffee. India produces 3.2% of world's coffee. Wherever compared to the world, India covers 3.2% of the production of coffee. It is the Arabic type of coffee brought up by British. Now coffee, it is brought up by British, and it is also grown in India today. Karnataka, Kerala and Tamil Nadu are the major coffee producing states. So these are the states which produce coffee the most. Then we have horticulture. India stands second in the production of fruits and vegetables. Horticulture means production of fruits and vegetables, and India stands second in the production of fruits and vegetables because the requirements of fruits and vegetables in India is more. India produces tropical and temperate fruits. It is included like tropical also and temperate fruits also. So India have the requirement of tropical as well as temperate fruits. Bananas are famous of Kerala, Mizoram, Maharashtra and Tamil Nadu. So we have different states having different kind of fruits, like Kerala, Mizoram and Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu. These are famous for bananas. Lychee and guava are famous of UP and Bihar. Pineapples are famous of Meghalaya. Grapes of Andhra Pradesh, Maharashtra and Telangana. Apples, pears, apricots, walnuts of Jammu Kashmir and Himachal Pradesh are famous worldwide. So different states have different kind of or different famous fruit. India produces world's 13% of vegetables. Okay, so India, wherever compared to the world, it has 13% of production of vegetables in India. Then we have rubber. It's equatorial crop but can be grown in tropical and subtropical regions also. Equatorial areas are those areas around the equator. So it also, but it also can be grown in the tropical and the subtropical areas also. It requires moist and humid climate with 25 degrees Celsius temperature. Means it needs a humid climate, not so hot, not so cold. It needs a humid climate, a moist climate with the requirement of 25 degrees Celsius around. It needs rainfall more than 200 centimeters. Means the requirement of rainfall is more than 200 centimeters. It's major industrial raw material. Now this, many manufacturing industries use rubber as their raw materials also. The major rubber producing states are Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Andaman and Nicobar Islands and Meghalaya. So these are the states which produce rubber the most. India stands fourth in the production of rubber. So India is ranking in the fourth position in the production of rubber. Now we have fiber crops. Fiber crops, first we have silk. Silk, it's obtained from the cocoons of silkworms. There are worms of silkworms which are giving silk. It is obtained from the cocoons of silkworms. They are fed on mulberry trees. Now wherever we find mulberry trees or wherever we find the mulberry leaves, these silkworms they produce silk. This process of rearing silkworms and obtain silk is called sericulture. So obtaining silk from the cocoons of the silkworm are called sericulture. Thank you.